Hi, Nancy. You have always kind of preached to us the importance of the three G's in your life, gambling, golfing, and garage sailing. And I would like to thank you for teaching me the importance of the three F's, which are being fun, being forthright, and the importance of family. So when it comes to fun, I have to say that most of my memories involving RHS, most of my fun memories involve you in some way, whether it was you always trying to get us to play games at department meetings, or you coming up with some kind of crazy stunt to enhance our assemblies, or even just stopping by your classroom to see the fun that you were having with your students. I really enjoyed that. And as someone who is serious, maybe too often, you've always been a good reminder that it's important to have more fun in life. So my second F that I've learned from you is being forthright. And Nancy, there is no one else I know but you who could get away with being so forthright and asking such tough questions, all with such charm and likability. I mean, I've always said that you could charm Hitler. And so you've really taught me that sometimes you just have to tell it like it is, and that's okay. So I've appreciated that. And then the most important lesson you've taught me has to do with family. And you've always kind of reminded us working moms of the importance of taking those days off so that we could be there with our own kids. So as someone who always kind of struggles with the mom guilt and balancing work, it's been really important to hear. Of course, though, my favorite lesson that you've taught me involving family is that it's okay to take a day off to yourself every now and again and not tell the kids about it. I mean, this is priceless information, which I will always remember. So thank you again for teaching me about the three F's, having fun, being forthright, and the importance of family. I love you so much, Nancy, and I'm so grateful to have you in my life.
Nancy, Daniela here. So there are so many things that I absolutely adore about you, as well as my Dotto girls. Number one, singing in the hallways at RHS and making anything and everything into a song. But by far the best was when we did Whitney Houston, "Oh, I Wanna Dance with Somebody," as we are literally leaping through your room in the hallways, and the students are sitting there like, "What's going on?" Number two, the way that you just inspire people and motivate people and just make life fun, including Shakespeare. Number three, your surprise visits to the Dedo household, like when you dressed up like an elf and your husband was Santa and brought the table that we still have today. All the books that you have from when you went garage sailing that you brought over, the surprise visit on Maria's B-Day, and then you took this fabulous photo. All so fun. Number four, playing with the girls and showing them how to take the sugar packets at restaurants and sliding them across the table to where they just get to the very, very end. And number five, being the reason that my daughter is named Julia, with bringing this book into my classroom saying, "I got you a book, hope you don't mind, it has a name on it." And lo and behold, that was our sign that we needed to name Julia, Julia. And I remember telling you, "Nancy, you're the reason my daughter got her name. You know it before anybody else." Anyway, love you, girl.
Hey Nancy, I just wanted to tell you that it has been an honor being your mentee. I was given the choice to pick my mentor when I moved from ARC to English, and you were my only choice because when I grow up, I want to be a teacher just like you. I want to still have that passion and that fire years into my career, still love my students, love my content area, but still be firm when I need to be. And that's what I learned from you. So I really appreciate all the life lessons and all the advice. I also really appreciate the fact that you threw your doctor's name into my lap when you saw I was in pain with my leg and made me go to the doctor. And then you came and got me every single day from the parking lot to make sure I didn't hurt myself on the ice. And I'll never forget that. You are the only person I allow to call me Spats, and that's going to remain because only you can do that. I love you, Nance. Bye.
Hi Nance, it's Cor. Just wanted to drop by and say hello. I've been thinking about you and all of the fun memories that we've had. One in particular comes to mind in thinking about Christmas time, the time that you and Santa stopped by for a visit. I don't know how many people know this story, but one time it was in the middle of winter, Christmas time. I hear the doorbell ring while I'm giving the boys a bath. And when I open the door, who's there? Nancy and Jim dressed up in a Santa Claus outfit. They came and brought the boys gifts for Christmas. I remember it, a big red remote control car and a helicopter. And the boy sat on Santa's lap and said what they wished for Christmas. And it was just a really awesome night. And actually, to this day, the boys still talk about the time Santa came to visit us. So, Nance, thank you for always, you know, being thoughtful and always being my number one cheerleader. Nancy, love you.
I just want to thank you for quite a few things. First off, thank you for helping me always look on the bright side of things and stay positive. You taught me how to appreciate everything in life. It was always my favorite when you would come into the big special ed office and scream "Ming" across the office and everybody would look, and I just felt honored to be your friend, honestly. I'll always remember when you came to visit me right after I had Emmett. That meant so much to me. I think you took a picture, or I took a picture with your phone of you guys. I'm not sure, but I'm angry with myself for not taking a picture, because that was such a great moment. I'll always remember how much you checked up on me when I was pregnant and would come and give me and Emmett hugs all the time and remind me that to let go of all the silly things because I had an amazing baby on the way. And when I was upset about my husband not wanting to go to India on Friday instead of Saturday, just being hormonal and crazy, you were there for me and helped set me straight. I'm so grateful that you've always taught me the importance of letting things go, especially recently. Last month when we Zoomed and we were both frustrated with remote learning, and you told me I gotta just be like Frozen and let it go, and you sang "Let It Go" to me. I'll always remember that, and I'll always sing that song whenever I get frustrated with school. It definitely helps. I've been doing it already. I'll always remember you in your little Debbie outfit. And the video that you sent me, I don't know if you remember this, but you took a video in your outfit, and it was like a Will Ferrell thing, and you were, mimicking him. Just really funny. As usual, you're always so funny. And then when you got sick and I reached out to the staff to get you that Coghill stuff, and there was just an outpouring of support and generosity. I mean, you have touched so many lives at Romeoville. Everyone loves you, and you don't have to be smart to figure out why. And I'm definitely honored to have been, or to be one of the people that you have touched. I love you so much, Nance.
Hey, Nancy, it's Straight here. I definitely want to let you know how much I just miss seeing you every single day. I love blowing in the office and hearing you yell out my name and tell me something crazy. One of the things that I think you're really awesome at too is making everybody feel like they're part of that department, even if they've only been there for 5 minutes. So I just want you to know I miss seeing your face, and you are one awesome human being.
Hi, Nancy. It's Melissa Higgins. I just wanted to say hello and wishing you all the best. Definitely miss seeing you at RHS and just always saying hello and checking in and asking me how I'm doing with my kids and whatnot. And I will say my favorite memory was when you dressed up as Little Debbie and you were walking around the hallway selling Little Debbie snacks for St. Baldrick's. You did anything to help fundraise money for that cause, and can't thank you enough for that. So again, wishing you best of luck, and we'll be thinking and praying for you every day.
Hi, Nancy. I hope you're feeling better. Stay safe and have a great day. Bye. Love you.
Bye. We love you.
Hey, Shasta. It's Harkness.
So 2014, I come back from summer vacation. I walk into my classroom and I find this sitting behind my desk. And I know exactly who it came from because that was our little joke. And I go down to the cafeteria and you're sitting at the table with the English teachers and you spot me and arms go up because you know exactly what I found. And then we received a second one. And Emily, little Miss Emily, has definitely enjoyed them over the past couple of years. And one of my favorite quotes is, laughter is the only thing that keeps us sane. And you have provided so much laughter to the halls of RHS over the years. And you could be anywhere in the building and you will recognize Shostak's voice coming down the hall, greeting everybody. So, Miss Emily, did you want to say anything?
Yeah, so... I say, make you all good.
You want to say thank you for the poppers?
And then say, I'm going to make you all good.
Okay, say it really loud.
And thank you for the poppers.
Okay. So we're going to say bye.
Bye.
Bye, Shostak. Say bye, Shostak.
Bye, Shostak. And make sure you say, I'm going to make you all better.
Hey, Nancy. So I just wanted to stop and leave a few words, leave my video on what I'm sure will be a very long compilation of videos from colleagues and friends and, you know, everybody at RHS. So the first thing I wanted to say was just thank you. And there's so much to say thank you for. I haven't really been a mentee in a few years, but you are definitely still my mentor. And you are the best mentor. I just can't thank you enough for really, it was tough coming to RHS. It was my first real teaching job. And you just, you know, as popular as you are and as beloved as you are and as many other things as you had going on, you always made time for me and looked out for me. And I really appreciate that. You made me feel really special, you know, when I first came to RHS, and you still do, through all of our conversations and things like that. I'm definitely missing your, you know, 7 p.m. calls for some Google advice or some tech advice. And it's been a real drag teaching this. I mean, our teaching, our learning in general, but definitely not being in the English office and having you come through every Friday to let us know, like, it's Friday. And just that energy, I've missed that this year. So, again, I will make this brief, but Nance, couldn't have asked for a better mentor, a better friend. Thank you so much. You have been and continue to be just a big part of who I am as a teacher. And all of my thoughts and love is with you and your family right now. Okay. Love you, Nance. Thank you so much. Oh, and last thing, speaking of technology and Google, I now have access to your 4th hour English 9 honors Google classroom, and I've graded it, I've judged it, and you are now a Google guru, Nancy. All the work, all the hard work has paid off from what I can see. You have mastered it. So you don't need me anymore. You can do that all on your own. All right. All right, Nance. Thank you again. Love you.
Hey, Nancy. It's Mrs. Lovano, only to you. I just wanted to let you know that I'm thinking about you and how much I miss you. I miss your positivity and your honesty, and most of all, your humor. You always make me laugh. So I hope this brings you a smile, and sending love and prayers and hugs your way.
Hi, Nancy, your library gal here. I just wanted to say hello. I hope you're having a good day, and thank you, because you've taught me a really good life lesson. I don't know if you remember this conversation we had one time, but someone was asking me to work on something or do something that was outside of what I wanted to spend my time on. And you had told me to be firm and stick up for myself and tell them that, no, I wasn't going to work on that project because it wasn't my project and problem to fix. So I had asked you, like, how do I just tell them no? And you said, you just go in there and you say, I'm not going to do that. And it worked. And I thank you for teaching me how to be bold and to stand up for myself. So I appreciate that very much. And I know that you like to gamble, and I thought I should tell you that recently I went to my shrink and I told them that I have a gambling problem. And I said, "Doctor, is there something that I can fix this problem?" And she said, "No dice." Love you, Nancy.
Hey, Shasti. It's me and my boyfriend, Jamie Frazier, dropping in to say hello. Just want to know that I'm thinking about you and that I miss you. Especially on days like this when I wear a leopard print sweater, because I know you'd give me some shit about it. So, again, thinking about you, wishing you the best, and I love you. Bye.
Hey, Nance. I'm here in my Superman shirt, which I wore for the teacher dance competition that you somehow talked me into. I don't know how you did it. That was like your superpowers, that you're able to persuade me to do something like that. But that's what we love about you, is just how much fun you bring, right? You remind us to have fun, not take things too seriously, kind of cut through the BS, all right? And just know that we love you so much and we support you, and just kind of sending all of that your way. Okay, Nance? Take care. We love you. Bye.
Hi, Nancy. It's Nikki, Annie, and Ella, and I just wanted to say hi to you and tell you that we're thinking about you. We know you're not feeling well, and we hope that you're having days where you feel much better. We're sending love and hugs your way, and can you say hi to Miss Nancy?
Hi, Miss Nancy.
Hi. Say, feel better.
Feel better.
And we love you.
We love you.
School Zoom sessions aren't the same without your jokes. We miss you so much. And we're thinking of you. Can you blow kisses? That's a good one. Bye, Nancy.
It's Randy here. We hope you feel better. And Polly wishes to be in the video, but he's at our grandma's house. And Grace and Charlotte are doing their work. And this is what I made for you, and there's something in here for you, and I hope, and this is gonna help you feel better, and I'm sorry that you're feeling sick. And then I'm gonna send it to your house. Bye. Bye.
I'm the new face of Little Debbie's Snack Cake.
I'm the new face of Little Debbie Snacks.
Singing. your kite.
With tuppence for paper and strings, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight. With your fist holding tight to the string of your kite. Oh, let's go fly a kite up to the highest height. Let's go fly a kite and send it soaring up through the atmosphere, up where the air is clear. Oh, let's go fly a kite. When you send it flying up there, all at once you're lighter than air. You can dance on the breeze over houses and trees. With your pistol and tight to the string of your kite.